I'm sorry, I've got to do this. Okay, your daughter-in-law, Sherry, and there's a wonderful young woman right there. She's got pretty.
Daughter Bella.
So
for the home. And we had a big day with the group yesterday. We had a Kentucky Derby party up at Trinity.
Oh, fun.
We all wore big hats and had a lot of fun. And
it was a wonderful horse that won. What it was, against all odds or whatever it was. I know. I love the Kentucky Derby. Nobody sneaks up on me.
Mark was our bookie.
Yeah. You were the bookie. Oh my gosh, did you?
Yeah, we placed bets and nobody won anything because of that force or whatever horse came in.
Yeah, it was wonderful. Under horse one.
Anyway, we're having fun and we will have to leave a little early today because we have a brunch to attend. But
how much fun!
Anyway, it's good to be with you all.
Oh, and it's so good to see you as well as and finally getting connected. That's good.
Yes. All right. That. Thank you, Carlos.
Thank you, Carlos. She said, for helping getting her connected today.
Oh.
So you're welcome. That's what you do. Oh, he said you're welcome, just so you know. All right. I think it's 10 o'clock by my clock, and it's good to see all of you this morning. Those of you in facility, it's wonderful to see you. So happy Mother's Day, all the moms there. So good that we're gathering. Did a lot of you wear orchids today?
No.
Do you guys remember? Those in facility, do you remember wearing the big bouquets or what do you call it? Corsages that you used to get from kids and stuff? It was so much fun. We did that in our church anyway. We really liked that. In the back of the bulletin on page 18, there's a prayer for mothers, and we're going to use that in a few minutes after the end of the announcements. Now that the COVID pandemic does seem to be running its course, probably isn't completely done, but it is for at this moment, at least enough so that we can transition to traditional full communion, which we begin next Sunday. Mm-hmm. The prepackaged elements, can't even say it, will continue to be available for those who prefer them. Of course, I think a lot of you are wondering who could prefer those, especially those in the facility. They struggle with those. So I'm going to take a moment, pastoral privilege here, and ask forgiveness for those frustrating communion elements. I know they've been troublesome for you, frustrating. So I say, I'm sorry. But I also say, I bless them, because without them, we would not have been able to have communion. We had it almost every Sunday during the pandemic. And that is pretty darn amazing. When I'm asked, why is your congregation still so active? Why does it have such a vibrant spirit? And I, of course, mention the spirit is with this congregation, that the lay leadership is astounding. It is amazing there, and all the wonderful congregants as well. But I also say communion. We're kept strong by the body of Christ through the elements of communion. And I think that's one of those things that this troublesome elements have made possible for us. And also one more thing. Did you know that when you lift up the bread, and you lift up the elements, you're partaking in a holy act that is usually reserved for those in clergy or those who are specially trained or those who are authorized. And I can't imagine any people more worthy of doing that than you guys. So I'm so proud of you for doing that. But anyway, next Sunday, we return to full traditional communion. And you remember how that goes. You'll be ushered forward, right? You stand or kneel at the altar rails. The presider will offer you a piece of bread. The assisting minister will offer wine or juice. You'll be blessed and you return to your pew. And I know it's all going to be, you know it so well, but just a review. And those on Zoom will continue using prepackaged elements or your individual ones. So those will be available too. So we have three options now. So good morning again. It's good that you're at worship today. Vern is our assisting minister. Dorothy is our reader. The musicians today are Gary, Dennis, and Jerry. Are there any other announcements? Oh, please, please, please. Of course. I think it's Dorothy.
I just wanted to let everybody know that the council was in agreement that on the third Sunday, we will be going back to having our potlucks. So next Sunday is potluck Sunday, and I'm sure it will continue through the summer and the fall. So the only change is you might want to bring something that is more like a lunch item than a snack item, I guess is how I would refer to that. And just one other little thing, I just want everybody to know, Bayshore Light Church will be using our fireside room on Thursdays. So they will be here two nights in the week, and then of course on their traditional Sunday.
What a blessing though, to have Bayshore Light Church. It really is, it's wonderful to have them. Are there any other announcements? If not, turn to that prayer that I mentioned on page 18. Did you find that in your bulletin? I'll read it for you, but let's pray silently together. Let us pray. Oh God, thank you for your gift of mothers, those gentle and fierce, strong and humble, kind and true. For they have raised us by their love, even cared enough to correct us. Oh God, grant mercy on mothers wounded by this broken world who have knowingly or unknowingly caused their children to suffer. Oh God, grant grace to us all where we have failed, forgive us and help us forgive ourselves. Oh God, thank you for those who have acted as mothers to us, whether grandmothers or aunts, sisters or friends, for we have seen your face in them. Oh God, grant peace to the mothers who have lost children, who have been separated from them, who have died from hunger, violence, and abuse. Help us find ways to help and comfort them. Oh God, although we cannot fully express our gratitude for your love of us, help us to be your blessing of love to others. Amen. It's time for our prelude by Gary.
Infamous words of my predecessor, something you've never heard before.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ah, wonderful. Thank you, Gary. Let's please stand for the peace. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always. We'll continue with the gathering hymn, Have No Fear, Little Flock.
Have no fear, little flock, have no fear, little flock, for the Father has chosen to give you the kingdom. Have no fear, little flock. Have good cheer, little flock, have good cheer, little flock, for the Father will keep you in his love forever. Have good cheer, little flock. Praise the Lord high above, praise the Lord high above, for he stoops down to heal you, uplift and restore you. Praise the Lord high above. Thankful hearts, praise to God, thankful hearts, praise to God, for he stays close beside you, in all things works with you. Thankful hearts, praise to God.
We'll continue with the confession. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who calls us beloved children, who gathers us into one flock, who guides us into all truth. Amen. Let us confess our sins, trusting that God will forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Faithful and just God, we confess that we are captive to doubt and fear, bound by the ways that lead to death. We have not loved our sisters and brothers as you have first loved us. Forgive us, God of mercy. Let your Holy Spirit work in us to change our lives and make us new, that we may know the abundant life given in Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. In this is love, that we have loved, not that we have loved God, but that God has loved us and sent the Son to atone for our sins. In the name of Jesus Christ, I announce to you that your sins are forgiven. Let the perfect love of God cast out fear, fill you with joy, and inspire you to live for others. Amen. Our next hymn of praise is, Here I Am, Lord.
Sky. I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save, will make the stars of night. I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord.
is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide. Till her heart be satisfied, I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send?
Whom shall I send?
Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go.
Thank you. Please be seated. Special music by Jerry and Dennis Crook. We didn't do the prayer, did we? You know what? I'm going to do the prayer. All right. I'm so anxious to hear Jerry and Dennis. So let us pray. God of peace, you brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep. By the blood of your eternal covenant, make us complete in everything good, that we may do your will and work among us all that is well-pleasing in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now Jerry and Dennis are going to sing.
The Lord's my shepherd. The 23rd Psalm has been translated and retranslated. It's one of the most favorite of the Psalms. And I find this version, which you have heard before, we've sung it, very interesting because it uses an old grammar form, which makes me think about what is being said and apply it. The second part is our pastoral response to the Good Shepherd.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me down to me to walk doth make within the paths of righteousness and for his own name's sake. Yea, though I walk in dark veil, yet will I fear no ill, for thou art with me, and thy rod and staff me comfort still. My
my table thou hast furnished in presence of my foes. My head thou dost with oil anoint, and my cup shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore my dwelling place shall be. As the deer panteth for, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You alone are my strength, my shield. My spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You're my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are my king. So much more than anything. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. I want you more than gold or silver, only you can satisfy. You alone are the real joy giver, and the apple of my eye. My shield, to you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee.
Yes, that was beautiful. We'll continue now with the readings.
The first reading is from Acts 9, 36 through 43. Dorcas was a faithful and devoted woman of charity in the community of Joppa. Her kindness and her work with clothing was well known, especially to the widows in town. When she fell ill and died, Peter raised her back to life through the power of prayer. A reading from Acts. Now in Joppa, there was a disciple whose name was Tabitha, which in Greek is Dorcas. She was devoted to good works and acts of charity. At that time, she became ill and died. When they had washed her, they had laid her in a room upstairs. Since Lydia was near Joppa, the disciples who heard that Peter was there sent two men to him with a request, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter got up and went with them. And when he arrived, they took him to the room upstairs. All the widows stood beside him, weeping and showing tunics and other clothing that Dorcas had made while she was with them. Peter put all of them outside, and then he knelt down and prayed. He turned to the body and said, "Tabitha, get up." Then she opened her eyes, and seeing Peter, she sat up. He gave her his hands and helped her up. Then calling the saints and widows, he showed her to be alive. This became known throughout Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. Meanwhile, he stayed in Joppa for some time with a certain Simon, a tanner. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'm just going to take a little moment to say a few things before I begin the psalm. Some of you may know I grew up I was in a church 50 plus years that was a Lutheran Church of the Good Shepherd. And we had a beautiful, not that this isn't beautiful, because it's very different, colorful picture of the Good Shepherd holding a lamb just like there, but with multiple lambs around him, except for one difference. One sheep was black. And our babysitter yesterday sent me an email of the picture of the window, because she was our babysitter when growing up. But she remembered the story about my father. My father was on the committee to work with the artist to design the Good Shepherd window. And of course, the artist wanted as many sheep as possible, but my father said, "No, we need one black sheep there. We need to let everyone know as they walk in here, everyone is welcome, even the black sheep." And so this window was put up, and people were sort of surprised, and it was interesting how the artist chose to put that black sheep. Of course, Christ had his long flowing robes on, and the black sheep was nestled against Christ, kind of almost being protected by his robe, where the other sheep were kind of off in a little bit of a distance, and then there was the one in his arms. And she asked, "Do you remember that story they always told in the church about your father?" So the Good Shepherd Sunday, it's very special for me to be reading, because of course, there has always been that thing of comfort for me in our Good Shepherd.
Thank you.
So Psalm 23, please read responsibly. "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want.
The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters.
You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever."
The second reading is from Revelation 7, 9 through 17. Christ is a shepherd who leads his faithful to springs of the water of life. Christ is also the Lamb who vanquishes sin and suffering, in whose blood the saints have washed their robes and made them white. A reading from Revelation. "After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They crowd out in a loud voice saying, 'Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb.' And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, 'Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen.' Then one of the elders addressed me saying, 'Who are these robed in white and where have they come from?' I said to him, 'Sir, you are the one that knows.' Then he said to me, 'These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. Here ends the readings.
Thanks be to God. The Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to John, the 10th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. At that time, the festival of the dedication took place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was walking in the temple in the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly." Jesus answered, "I have told you, and you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name testify to me, but you do not believe, because you do not belong to my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they will follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else, and no one can snatch it out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord. Over the last couple of years now, many of us have felt unsettled that the solid ground of our lives no longer seems as safe, but more threatening. Jesus' first followers felt much the same. Maybe that's why Jesus took such care to promise that he is the good shepherd who will protect them, sustain them, lay down his life for them. These first followers needed to hear it, that they were not, they'll not just get through their present difficulties, but will also experience life and joy to the fullest. Perhaps like me, you need to hear that too. One time when my life was very difficult, I was exhausted. I just kept trying to keep everything going and everyone going. So my grandmother quoted a New Testament verse to me that I should do like she did and run with perseverance the race that is set before us. Well, this verse isn't always helpful, for it seems to indicate we need to add something more to our to-do list, to add to our already exhausted nature. What we really need sometimes is to hear about hope. Hope, which can be found in unusual places. But during that same time that I was having a rough time, my boss, Della, was too. Unexpectedly, she handed me an old Bible and asked me to find the verses about Jesus, the Good Shepherd. I don't know why she did that. I think she thought I could just find it. I was a Sunday school teacher after all. Eventually I found John chapter 10. That's the same chapter as today's reading, but I read it to her from the first part of the chapter, which included the verses that would take my breath away. Verses that would change my life. In these verses, Jesus said, "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep." At the moment I read them, these breathtaking words worked deep within me. For I heard the good news that Jesus came to give us, even me, life in abundance, now and forever. These words still work in me. They still give me hope. In today's last reading, we heard more about the Good Shepherd. There Jesus said, his people hear his voice and they follow him. There's two promises there. I hope you heard them. For Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else, and no one can snatch it out of the Father's hand. Jesus said, did you hear? That his sheep knows the shepherd's voice. They won't listen to thieves and bandits and will run from strangers. In other words, Jesus was confident in the relationship between the sheep and the shepherd, between you and him. For Jesus, the good shepherd, knows we trust him, that we've trusted him in the past and that we'll continue to trust him. And Jesus said, the sheep will follow. He knows we'll be able to tell the difference between false hope and real hope. We'll discern between genuine offers of abundant life and all those fakes being sold to us. For Jesus promises that he'll lead us and that we will follow him. So we may wonder, at least I do, how Jesus can be so confident in us. After all, Jesus' followers, including us, including me, have a history of falling short. For whether life is easy or difficult, we slip up, we sin, we think we're in control. But then this confidence isn't about the sheep's faithfulness, but about the shepherd's. Yes, it's about Jesus, not about us. Like God the Father, Jesus is steadfast love and faithfulness. Today we hear that in his promises not to allow anyone or thing, not even ourselves, snatch us away from him. You see, Jesus is saying to us, I've got this. And he does. He lays down his life and rises again to bring us new life. You know, it's that Easter thing. For Jesus makes two promises. First, about what he's going to do for us, protecting, providing, caring, sacrificing, giving life. And second, he promises how we'll respond to him, trusting, listening, embracing, thriving, living eternally. And this is really good news. This is such good news for us, for too many of us get tired. We get tired. We're exhausted. We doubt whether we can endure, wonder how we can continue living through what feels like all day and all night crisis mode. How comforting it is to know not only that Jesus has us, but that we'll get through. For that's what the good shepherd promises. Like St. Paul said in Romans 8, if God is for us, who can be against us? And then Paul lists peril and famine and violence and a whole bunch more things that could overcome us. I'm sure we could add a few of our own. And then Paul asked, will any of these defeat us by separating us from God's love? To which Paul declared emphatically, no, no, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through the one who loves us. It's a fact. Our times are complicated and unsettled, but what a joy to know Jesus and his eternal promises to be with us and for us. And that Jesus is confident we're going to listen to him and enter into the abundant life he offers. In this we can trust. In this we can be confident. We can have faith. We can have hope. Thanks be to God. Amen. We're going to sing, please stand, Lord of all hopefulness. Please stand.
Skill that the blame and the way, be there.
hands with to welcome, your arms to embrace. Be near our longing and give us, we pray, your love in our hearts, Lord, at the eve of the day. Lord of all gentleness, Lord of all calm, whose voice is contentment, whose presence is balm.
We'll continue with the Apostles' Creed.
With congregations around the world, we confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Trusting God's promise of new life, we pray for the renewal of the church, the world, and all of creation. Shine your light through this and every congregation. Reveal to us the light of your salvation in places of hopelessness and decay. Anoint us and make us overflow with goodness and mercy. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We give thanks for gentle rains that nourish green pastures and rejuvenate rivers and streams. Provide clean water for thirsty people, animals, and crops. Heal places suffering destructions caused by floods, typhoons, storms, and mudslides. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Empower authorities to be faithful shepherds who lead nations in pathways of righteousness and peace. Disrupt and deter the work of terrorists, religious and political extremists, and all who would choose the way of violence over the way of mercy. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Give us strength and perseverance to those facing struggles of hunger or thirst, unemployment or homelessness, chronic illness or anxiety. Be our never-failing voice of comfort through all the trials of this life. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Raise up faithful women as witnesses to your strength and compassion. Bless mothers and all who would offer mothering care. Protect victims of sexism, abuse, and gender-based violence. Restore dignity to those marginalized because of their gender identity or sexual orientation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray today for all those on our prayer concerns list and also our members and all of our members and friends of Calvary. This week, especially, we pray for Carolyn, Deborah, Michael, Nancy, Larry, and their family, Robert, Mike and Dana, and Harper, as well as our members and friends serving us in the military, and our partners in ministry, Christ Lutheran, our Saviors, Emmanuel, Lutheran Church of Arcata, Grace Good Shepherd, and our bishops, Bishop Rohr and Bishop Eaton. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Salvation belongs to you, O God. You promise to wipe away every tear. Give us the assurance that all who live and die in you will rest forever beside the river of life. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. We commend these and all our prayers to you, O God. Come near to us with your saving help. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, ruler of heaven and earth. Day by day you shower us with blessings of you, as you have raised us to new life in Christ. Give us glad and generous hearts, ready to praise you and to respond to those in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Gather the elements for communion. For many of you, this will be the last time you'll be using these little troublesome prepackaged elements. But remember what you're doing when you lift these elements up. Truly, truly, that's a holy act. And I'm so proud of you for doing that. So let's together make the sign of the cross as these words are said in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Holy and loving God, we praise you for creating the heavens and the earth. We bless you for bringing Noah and his family through the waters of the flood, for freeing your people Israel from the bonds of slavery, and for sending your Son to be our Redeemer. We give you thanks for Jesus, who living among us healed the sick and fed the hungry. Then with a love stronger than death, he gave his life for others. So here we go. Please lift the bread. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please eat of the bread, the body of Christ given for you. Please lift the cup. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please drink of the cup, the blood of Christ shed for you. Remembering, therefore, his life-giving death and glorious resurrection, we await your promised life for all this dying world. Breathe your spirit on us and on this bread and cup. Carry us in your arms from death to life, that we may live as your chosen ones, clothed in the righteousness of Christ. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Special music by Gary. Beautiful. Thank you, Gary. It's a communion blessing, so I invite you to stand. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Life-giving God, we give you thanks for nourishing us with the bread of heaven and the wine of love. Jesus, our risen Savior, as you send us into the world, guard us from the power of evil. Keep us in unity with all your people, and by your Spirit move us to testify to your grace in our words and action. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Our final blessing. The God of all grace, who has called you to eternal glory in Christ, restore, support, and strengthen you and bless you by the power of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. All right, now we get to sing the song, Savior, like a shepherd, lead us.
shepherd, lead us. Much we need your tender care. In your pleasant pastures, feed us. For our use, your food prepare. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, you have bought us, we are yours. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, you have bought us, we are yours. We are yours in love, befriend us, be the guardian of our from sin, defend us, seek us when we go astray. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, hear us children when we pray. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, hear us children when you have promised to receive us, poor and sinful though we be. You have mercy to relieve us, grace to cleanse and power to free. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, early let us turn to you. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, early let us turn to you. Early let us seek your favor, early let us do your will. Blessed Lord and Holy Savior, with your love our spirits fill. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, you have loved us, loved us still. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, you have loved us, love us still.
Please be seated for Gary Klimt's postlude. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you, Gary.
Please unmute if you're on Zoom. Go in peace. Make God's love known. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
Wonderful. Thank you all. Happy Mother's Day to everyone.
You too.
See you in the facility. What? Oh, Penny too. Yes. Penny, happy Mother's Day. Yes. Ooh, yes. Wonderful to see your family, Bev.
Yes.
Have a wonderful brunch. Thank you, ladies. You were wonderful. Appreciate your attention. See you later. Bye-bye. I am tuning you out.
Okay.